Hi everyone and welcome to Usitility. Well, we are going to see how to play Lord of Heroes on PC. As you can see, you can watch it on your screen. It takes almost no time to effortlessly download and install Lord of Heroes so that we can play this game on a Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and large monitor. Then it's time to have fun. Let's go, my friends. Before anything else, folks, the first thing to do is to open our favorite web browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to this URL that I'm highlighting in green. Now, you can see on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type anything, because there's the clickable link in the video description and the first pinned comment. We arrived here on the website of Usitility, where we get an in-depth outline on the way to download Lord of Heroes on PC. We browse down a little bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on the link, we reach the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to play Lord of Heroes on the PC. As you can see here, we have several pros of running the emulator. Then, we will proceed to download the Lord of Heroes by clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green. We then click on it. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Here it is, this is the download. It's a file to execute. What we have to do is to launch the installer. Okay, so we click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make changes to the computer. We have said yes. I reduce the browser to view the installer better. The installation software is quite simple. It includes two options, install and setup path. I am going to clarify what setup path does indeed. We purely click on it. And then we see that we have now here the path where the emulator will be set up. If we need to modify this folder, we need to click on the Browse button. Therefore, we decide on another directory and install the emulator specifically where we desire. To keep it simple, just keep it by default. Then, I click on Back. And therefore, I click on Install. Great! The installation begins and it's going to continue together with the download of these megabytes that happens to be displayed on the screen. The time you save it on your machine, it could be a little more or less MB. The data transfer speed might go at a higher speed or slower, depending on your internet and according to the efficiency of the emulator hosting servers. Today they are running extremely fast. The download is finished, and at this point it continues with the installation step. The installation will need a little bit more or less time depending on the power of your PC. The more efficient it's actually, the shorter the setup time and or vice versa. If we join the download and setup step, it may take quite a long time, so be patient. It is now completely finished for me. At this point, the emulator has been launched instantly. As you will notice, down here, there's a progress bar that will fill up so when it actually reaches the finish, the emulator can be launched for the first time. The reality is the emulator has already been launched, here for the first time. Before we continue on, as you can see, it made two icons here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon will be one we are interested in. The moment we need to operate Lord of Heroes on our laptop or computer, we double-click this specific icon and launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance app icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or anything like that. The fact is that, it's an icon that we will probably never ever start using. We should do the following step, that is a must, and that's to entry the Google Play Store. As you will notice, the Google Play is launched. There we need to sign in. Right now when we are there, we must accomplish the following step that is definitely obligatory. So we click on Sign In. At this point it says Checking Info. It may from time to time get stuck in Checking Info, and this doesn't progress. In that case, you can try to log in after a few hours and it'll most certainly be resolved. At this point we are going to type in our username and password. The email has to be a Gmail email address as well as its corresponding password. For example, you can use the same exact email you use at this time in your own YouTube account. Therefore, I am going to type my information and I will come back immediately after I have accomplished it. That's all. Data inserted. And here is Google welcoming us and offering us the terms of service. We can consent to them by clicking on I agree. After that, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You could leave it checked and it'll build a backup of the data on this device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you do what you want. We simply click on accept. The Google Play Store is launched automatically and instantly. To install the app game, we have to visit the emulator desktop for Android by clicking this icon indicated green colored. Currently that we are on the desktop of this Android emulator, we see that we now have here the install application option. We just click on the button. At this point we have the video game. Why don't we click on there on the install option that I am showing now in green. This will start the setup. At this point it will download and install the video game. It normally takes some time or it may be almost immediate. It again all relies on our internet access. It's actually completed installing. Back to the emulator desktop by clicking on that button that I am presenting in green, to be able to run Lord of Heroes for the very first time. Shall we click on that My Games option above? I am already on the emulator desktop, and consequently we are going to just click on this brand new Lord of Heroes software icon that's been created. That game is launched for the first time. There we have it, I'm able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to comment on the volume level of this emulator. It is here, we have the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we won't depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of your emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the max, we could turn on the big screen, for which we have two choices. That is the first one, we just click on this icon that I'm showing in green. Then the screen is maximized, coming with one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In the case that we want to experience the video game in full screen, we select this game icon. So we would by now be experiencing the game in full screen mode. To get out of the complete screen mode, push the F11 key. And we might at present end up being in normal computer screen mode. From now, I am going to present you the computer keyboard mapping which is actually extremely enjoyable. That way we will certainly be able to play the game application much more easily. The first point is to click this application icon. It's now time to get the required configurations. I am about to keep the standard settings, but if you like to change this, you may well achieve it without any problem. As you can notice, the emulator is completely in our language. In some cases it happens that the emulator is launched in the incorrect language, for instance, in Chinese. So to set it in the correct language we go here to the cogwheel. So here inside of additional settings, we simply click on the language drop down. We can also pick the language we wish, English, Chinese, etc. As soon as the language is determined, we should save, the emulator would reboot, along with the video game, next time we run it, would also be in the preferred language. At this time, there is another element that we will need to take into account, and it is that we will receive an email reporting that a brand new device has been connected to this Google account. It will definitely question us if we are the individuals who have connected that device. Absolutely, we shouldn't worry, because the emulator is behaving like a Google Android smartphone or tablet. And then to see which electronic device is being emulated, we arrive here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. Be sure to go here to the model choice. And right here we discover that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for this training. I hope you liked it, particularly that you thought it was helpful. If that's the case, give it a pleasant thumb up, subscribe to our channel, and I will be happy to answer your feedback, concerns or suggestions, let them in the comment box below. You can also comment things on my Twitch channel, I conduct live streams occasionally, you have it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Check out any of these videos which are usually appearing on the list of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the future video game videos. Bye.